Hello and welcome to the Property Show North Special. I am Chanakya Bhatia. This show is just for you. Your budget, our data-backed advice to help you make the right choice when making the biggest decision of your life, buying a home. With me in the studio is Sameer Jasuja, founder and MD Prop Equity, to advise you when you call in with your questions. Here's what we have on the show today. Suffering home buyers of Haryana may have to wait longer for a regulator in the state as the matter of appointment gets stuck in administrative tangles. A special report on what's happening on the ground. In a continuing series of highlighting delivery delays by developers, today we bring in the report card of Noida-based Gardenia Group, which has failed to deliver its project on time, leading to uncertainty for over 4,500 buyers. Sectors along the Noida Expressway and sectors near Metro to be explored for project options in a budget starting from 70 lakhs to a crore. Projects from reputed developers in the new Gurgaon and Dwarka Expressway region for 1 crore. We will also look into livable destinations of Jaipur in 50 lakhs. Today we will also visit a new residential market, Agra, for affordable options in 45 lakhs. And we will also tell you about projects with good amenities in Zirakpur near Chandigarh in a range of 60 to 65 lakhs. And our focus will be upon Noida, Gurgaon, Ghaziabad and Jaipur property markets. We have a first caller. It's Dr. Gaurav Agarwal joining us on the phone line. Yes, sir. How can we help you?
Hello, sir. So I want to buy a flat and I have two options on my mind. Mahagun Modern in Sector 78, Noida. And Amrapali Silicon City in Sector 76.
Okay.
And my budget is 70 to 75 lakhs. So please guide me which one of these will be the better option for me.
Okay. So Sameer, 70 to 75 lakh is the budget and Central Noida he is looking at. So what do you suggest?
So first of all, the budget is pretty decent. Out of the two projects chosen by you, Mahagun project is a much better project. The Amrapali project has concerns of OC, poor quality construction, and maintenance issues are also there, and there are concerns there, although families have moved in. So we would advise you to stay away from that project. However, Mahagun's project, which I'll share a few details with for our other viewers, a modern project spread over 25 acres, offering a mix of low-rise, high-rise apartments. Project is located on the main internal road in Sector 78 and 5.8 kilometers from the Noida city center. The project is also operational. It's got an operational retail area called Mahagun Mart and Manthan School. Within the premises, besides the project, has 6 acres of large central park, Leander Pace Tennis Academy, Music Dance Academy. So a lot of amenities over here as well. Looking at the key data points of this micro market, 20 months of inventory overhang, so it's safe. We're talking about projects that are ready. So keep that in mind with respect to this data point. Mid-segments, weighted average price is 5,350 rupees a square foot for ready projects. And the price appreciation for ready projects has been about 8% on an annualized basis. We've got one more recommendation for you. The Hyde Park by Nimbus Projects Limited, trading at 5,000 rupees. This is also a very good project, ready, available from the resale market. It's got a 50,000 square feet clubhouse with a swimming pool, gym, sauna and steam. Project is spread across 15 acres, it's 6.5 kilometers from Noida city center metro station. It's got good internal roads in Sector 78. It's three side open and faces a green belt. So these are some of the big positives of this project as well.
And also the connectivity is also improving and metro is also coming down the line. And it is a go-ahead for Mahagun Modern by Mahagun India. Also, you have another option in your budget, which is the Hyde Park by Nimbus Projects. Next, we have Dr. Dheeraj on the phone line. Yes, Dheeraj, ask your question. Yes, Dheeraj, can you hear me?
I'm hearing you. Actually, first of all, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And आपको compliment भी दे रहा हूँ कि आप जो show बना रहे हैं इससे genuine advice मिलती है.
Thank you so
मेरा
much, sir.
जो मेरा question है वो related है राजनगर extension गाजियाबाद UP से. वहाँ पर एक अजनारा इंटीग्रिटी का project है जो कि 1425 square feet 3 BHK दे रहे हैं. वो मैंने book किया है. और उसका पेशेंट डिलेड हो रहा है तो मेरा पहला क्वेश्चन है कि वो पोजीशन कब तक मिलेगा एंड सेकंड इन्वेस्टमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से वो एरिया कैसा है.
ठीक है. सो समीर ही वांट्स टू नो अबाउट राजनगर एक्सटेंशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाउ मच रिटर्न ही कैन एक्सपेक्ट. आल्सो ही वांट्स टू नो अबाउट द प्रोजेक्ट.
या on a standalone basis, this project is a good choice. The phase one of this project is already delivered and families are staying in. Phase two is supposed to be delivered in a couple of months. And lastly, phase three is going to be delivered in mid-2017. However, this is a project of a large scale and there could be further delays. But right now, things seem to be on track for 2017 delivery at some point in time. The amenities of this project are pretty good. They're offering you a clubhouse with billiards table, tennis court and squash court. The project is 2.3 kilometers from NH58 and bang on the Meerut bypass road. Looking at the data points of this micro market, please do not expect too much appreciation. The market has an inventory overhang of 32 months. The mid segment's weighted average price is about 3,000 rupees a square foot and annualized appreciation is about 6%. As such, if you look at the supply numbers, there's about 32,000 apartments that are going to be coming up in the next 3 to 4 years with 71 projects. That's a huge amount of supply. Although the price point is very, very comfortable at 3,000 rupees, and you know, your project's current resale price is about 2,900 rupees a square foot for the under construction part. And the current developer price is 31 to 3200 rupees on a 50-50 plan. And you, I'm told, have invested at 3,600 rupees, so you're also not in a very good situation. It's a loss right now, so you'll have to really hold on and wait for the tide to turn and wait for the project to be completely delivered, for families to be fully living in, all the infrastructure around that coming up in a much better way. And then maybe you can expect some price appreciation.
And Sameer, talking about Rajnagar extension for other viewers, do you think it is one of the best and most affordable micro market in NCR at present moment, and it is giving tough competition to locations like Greater Noida West?
Well, as far as best is concerned, there I will reserve my comments. As far as affordable is concerned, most definitely it's one of the most affordable micro markets in and around the NCR region. But it has also got competition from Noida Extension, from Greater Faridabad, and now also you could even say that the Greater Sohna area is also trying to compete with the same for the same customers. So that is pretty much the four micro markets which are at that 3,000 rupee price level.
And coming back to your answer, Sameer has suggested that you should hold onto your project, Ajanara Integrity by Ajanara India. And if you want to buy a property or need any advice on buying a home, please write to us at property@ndtv.com. Please don't forget to leave your full name and contact number so that our team can get in touch with you. We have another caller joining us on the show. It is Aditya who is calling us from the United States of America. Welcome to the show, Aditya. Tell us what you want to know.
Hi, so my name is Aditya, and actually I'm looking as an end user in US. So I've been moving in Gurgaon within 6 months.
Okay.
And the property that I've shortlisted is, one is DLF New Town Heights in Gurgaon, sector 86 and 90.
Okay.
The second is Raheja Sheila's in sector 109. Mm-hmm. The third is Chintal Paradiso, and that's also in sector 109. Mm-hmm. Then fourth is Best Tech Parkview in sector 81, and fifth is Tulip Violet, sector 69. So I'm looking for an end user, going to settle down in 6 months.
Okay.
And I was looking for an area that you think that going to get developed, and that I can live, that I can plan to live in 6 months.
Okay. So, okay. We'll help you on that. So Sameer, what do you suggest?
Well, this is a very tough question as such, since you're living in the US and you have a pretty reasonable budget for New Gurgaon region and Dwarka Expressway region, which both micro markets are very good from a very long-term perspective in terms of appreciation. As far as livability is concerned, since you're living in the US, the social infrastructure in both the places is not up to the mark for you to be able to really enjoy a great living over there. I would highly recommend you to buy one of these places from an investment point of view and move on rent at least for the next 2 to 3 years till social infrastructure starts to develop in these micro markets. However, if you were to look at your choices made, four out of the five choices made are pretty good. So we've ranked them and this is from an appreciation point of view. Not really from a livability point of view and from a project point of view. So we think Chintal's Paradiso is the first recommendation, which is in a very good sector. Sector 109 is proximity to Delhi. It's a low density sector. So we kind of like sector 109 a lot with respect to all the other sectors in the Dwarka Expressway belt. This project is also a part of a 400-acre integrated township, so all the benefits of a township will accrue to you in this. Fantastic amenities and specifications. It's also specified as a green project by IGBC. It's got a gold rating for this project. Construction is in finishing stages. Initial works of for most towers being completed is being handed over, is being done right now. The second recommendation from the second ranking from our side would be the Violet by Tulip Infrastructure, Sector 69. This is a project that is more livable actually because it's in the golf course extension belt. This project is spread across 17 acres, total of 24 towers. The project is in finishing stages and likely to be handed over by late 2016. Again, they have amenities which are pretty decent. Third recommendation is Parkview Ananda, Sector 81, Bestech Group. This is the new Gurgaon region. The project has an excellent location on the main sector road. The project is around 500 meters from NHO8 and apartments consist of split ACs, modular kitchen and wooden flooring as well. Then we move on to DLF New Town Heights, a very affordable project. It's from the DLF stable. They've got many sectors that they own which will they make beautiful townships of, and this big township is going to be called the Garden City Township over there. This project is spread across 23 acres. There are a total of 13 towers of G+22 structures. The project is in finishing stages and few of the amenities are still to be created. So the key data points of these micro markets, the Delhi side of the Dwarka Expressway has got 14 months of inventory overhang. The new Gurgaon region 19 months and if you look at the weighted average price for the Delhi side of Dwarka Expressway is about 6,550 rupees a square foot. New Gurgaon region is about 4,750 rupees a square foot and the sectors between Sona Road and NHO8 is about 6,300 rupees a square foot. On the price appreciation charts, all three micro markets, although quite far away from each other, are showing similar appreciation percentages. Delhi side of Dwarka Expressway stands at about 7% odd, the new Gurgaon region at 7.5%, and the sectors between Sona Road and NHO8 is about 6% odd on an annualized basis.
So let me just sum up everything for you, Aditya. We have ranked and your shortlisted option also. We suggest that you avoid Raheja Shila's project, and the projects which gets a go ahead from our side are New Town Heights by DLF, Chintals Paradiso by Chintals India, Parkview Ananda by Bestech Group, and Violet by Tulip Infrastructure. Next, we have an email query from Shri Lekha Mukherjee. She is looking to buy a 3 BHK ready to move in option at Noida Expressway or Greater Noida. Her budget is around 50 lakhs. Now, Sameer, is 50 lakhs budget for 3 BHK is enough for Noida Expressway?
Well, definitely not, especially when you're talking about a ready project. You'll have to up your budget quite substantially to get a good project on the Noida Expressway, which is also ready. However, Greater Noida at these price points seems to be a better micro market to get a decent sized flat which is ready, and the prime area of Greater Noida, which is the area around Pari Chowk, is where you can even manage some projects as such, and the Yamuna Expressway is the other micro market that we are recommending to you. So let's straight away jump on to the key data points of these two micro markets. The region around Pari Chowk has got a safe inventory overhang of 18 months and Yamuna Expressway is about 10 odd months. The mid-segment's weighted average price for region around Pari Chowk is 3,450 rupees a square foot, and Yamuna Expressway is about 3,200 rupees a square foot. The price appreciation for areas around Pari Chowk is about 5%, and Yamuna Expressway is about 4.5%. The three recommendations from our side are Palm Greens by Omax at 3,500 rupees a square foot. Palm Greens is spread across 23 acres of land, located in Omnicon 2, 8 kilometers from Pari Chowk. Amenities here include steam, sauna, jacuzzi, cafeteria. The project is ready to move in. Possession was handed over last year itself. Express Parkview 1 by Nimbus Projects, Sector Chai 5, a project which has got 3.5 acres of landscape park, a well-equipped clubhouse, swimming pool, toddler's pool as well. The project is again ready to move in. Possession was handed over in late 2014. It's 2 kilometers from the Gautam Buddha University, spanning across 510 acres. Lastly, we have ABJ Heights by ABJ Group, Sector Zeta 1 at 3,000 rupees a square foot. The project has 11 towers. The project has modern amenities like swimming pool, kids playing area, yoga gym area as well. And the project is located on the main road, 5 to 7 kilometers from Pari Chowk.
So you have plenty of options, but not in Greater Noida You have in Greater Noida, but not in Noida Expressway. So Palm Greens by Omax Limited is one. Second, Express Park View, one by Nimbus Projects. And the third option which you have in your budget is AVJ Heights by AVJ Group. Next, we have Abhishek Solanki joining us on the phone line. Yes, Abhishek, how can we help you?
Yeah, hello, sir. Very good evening to all of you. I have a question. I'm looking for a property in Jaipur and on Ajmer Road. And my budget is around 35 to 50 lakhs. Mm-hmm. My primary objective is investment. But okay. In future, I might be moving to Jaipur. But that plan is after 5 years. Mm-hmm. Also, I thought of it will be good if I'm close to the city, like near to civil lines or Sodala. Mm-hmm. And one person suggested me a property that was Shivraj Residency by Shiv Shakti Group. It's in Omex, second phase.
Okay. So, Sameer, what do you suggest?
Well, from our side, Shivraj Residency is a go-ahead. It's close to the Mahindra SEZ project. Omax City already is inhabited with 400 families already having shifted in. Therefore, as you have mentioned, you might shift in this property after 3 years and your preferred location of work will be Mahindra SEZ. This will be a very good bet for end use. Coming to the key data points of the project is spread across 21,000 square yards. The developers coming up with 7 towers in this project. Amenities here include a clubhouse, swimming pool, semi-modular kitchen with hob and chimney. They're offering you a 1.5-acre garden as well. Looking at the key data points of Ajmer Road and the other micro market where we've got some recommendations for you is Mansarovar Extension. The inventory overhang is 27 months for Ajmer Road and Mansarovar Extension is 20 months. For all segments, the weighted average price of Ajmer Road is 2950 rupees a square foot and Mansarovar Extension is 3400 rupees. The price appreciation trends for Ajmer Road are about 7% and Mansarovar Extension are about 7.5% on an analyzed basis. The two more recommendations from our side to you for looking at Jaipur micro market are Mansarovar Extension, Platina Terraces in Anukampa by Anukampa Builders. This project is spread across 8 bighas, having a total of 4 blocks. Here, the amenities are quite superb, I must say. 50,000 square feet clubhouse, mini theater, shopping arcade, skating ring, and the subvention scheme is available with Tata Capital. The project is 4.1 kilometers from the new Sanganer Road, Mansarovar Colony. Then we have Sunshine Prime by Dhanuka Group at 3,700 rupees a square foot. The total project area is 5,000 acres, excellent amenities including private terraces of 1,000 square feet per floor, AC apartments, infinity swimming pool at the 10th floor, and zero monthly maintenance for 5 years. That's a big plus as well.
So your shortlisted option, which is a Shiv Raj Residency by Shiv Shakti Group, gets a go-ahead from our side. Also, you can look into other projects in this budget. One is Platina Terraces by Anukampa Builders, and another one is Sunshine Prime by Dhanuka Group. Buyers of BPTP projects in Gurgaon and Faridabad got together and staged a protest at Jantar Mantar, Delhi. Agitated buyers shouted slogans and demanded the possession of their flats from the developer. Many buyers are waiting to get possession of their flat since 8 years. Buyers also alleged that the developer has taken unjustifiable charges on account of super area increase. Several home buyers of BPTP have gone from pillar to post to claim their right but were turned down from everywhere. The protesting buyers demanded the state government's intervention against the developer. They have also demanded a nodal officer be appointed to ensure projects are completed and people get their houses soon. There are at least 15 BPTP's projects witnessing average delays of more than 3 years, with over 5,000 units stuck in limbo.
मेरे जैसे 4,100 भाई बहनों ने ग्रेटर फरीदाबाद में बीपीटीपी एलीट प्रोजेक्ट के अंदर जो 75 सेक्टर से लेकर 79 सेक्टर तक फैला हुआ है उसके अंदर हम लोगों ने मई 2009 में अपने फ्लैट बुक कराए थे। बिल्डर ने हमसे 2011 तक 85% पेमेंट ले ली। उसके अलावा हमें 2012 में उसने पोजीशन देने का वादा किया। 2012 से लेकर आज 2016 मई तक हम खड़े हुए हैं।
और मैं बीपीटीपी पार्क लाइट प्रीमियम से आया हूँ। 2009 में प्रोजेक्ट लिया था, 2013 में मिलना था, अभी तक कुछ नहीं मिला। इसके अगेंस्ट में मैंने पीएमओ पर अपने कंप्लेन रजिस्टर्ड करी है। कंप्लेन वहाँ पे दो बार रजिस्टर्ड करी, दोनों बार स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को फॉरवर्ड कर दी गई और फाइनली उन्होंने बोल दिया कि केस हैज बीन क्लोज्ड।
इन दिल्ली एनसीआर, नोएडा वाज वंस अ हॉट स्पॉट फॉर पीपल लुकिंग टू बाय देयर फर्स्ट होम, बट नाउ पोटेंशियल होम बायर्स आर गिविंग इट अ मिस एंड एवरीवन नोज व्हाई। Delays in possession has brought sentiment down to all-time low, and the actions of a few developers are worsening the problem. In a continuing coverage of project delays, we look at the Gardenia Group, whose project structure is ready. Payment has been done, but the possession of the flats is far from reality. Let's take a look. Gardenia Glory project in Sector 46, Noida, was launched in 2009. The project, which was supposed to be ready and handed over in 2012, is still under construction.
I booked my flat in year 2010, and since then I'm waiting to get this particular flat. Although we have paid almost 90% of the payment 2.5 years back, and we are paying EMI and everything, but there is no progress on my flat. My flat is on 12th floor. I go by stairs to check if there is any progress onto it. There is no progress since last 2 years.
If that wasn't bad enough, buyers in the project are also worried over several issues which might create problems in the future.
The biggest issue is presently the property is mortgaged thrice. Firstly, it is the land payments have not been done to the Noida Authority. So the whole project, in fact, the land belongs to Noida Authority. Unfortunately, builder has further mortgaged the same properties to OBC, a consortium of three banks, and they claim that the property belongs to them.
This is yet another case where buyers' hard-earned money has been put at risk by the developer. And the problems don't end with just this project. There are other projects of Gardenia Group which are running behind schedule. As per industry sources, Gardenia Gateway, launched in 2011, is still under construction. Gold City Phase 1 and 2 in Sector 75 is running behind schedule. Gitanjali Digi Homes in Ghaziabad is delayed by more than 2 years. Gardenia Group, in its defense, has issued a statement to NDTV. On the overall delay in the projects, the company said, and I quote, "Projects are delayed due to various reasons. Major factors in delay of these projects are farmers' agitation, entity issues and delay in getting land acquisition because of Noida Authority. On various dues pending with authority and the bank, the company responded by saying, and I quote, "We have time to make the next installment till 30th June 2016. And rest installment has been scheduled by end of year 2019. We have also settled the issue with OBC Bank." The company also added, and I quote, that "we have already started offering the possession for fit-out work in almost all our projects. Very soon, we will hand over the project," unquote. Legal experts believe that developers taking shelter under the garb of an external agency will not hold any ground in the court of law.
In this case, the delay subsequent thereto from the date of possession, which is to be handed over, has to be paid by the builder. There is no question about it. So here, the builder cannot take any pretext or any protection of the NGT ruling. In this case, it is absolutely not where any benefit could be accrued to the builder.
As per sources, Gardenia Group owes over 150 crore rupees to OBC Bank, and it has to pay nearly 400 crores to the Noida Authority as land dues. It is unclear how the company plans to raise funds to settle this. Buyers are demanding legal possession of the flats, which might be difficult until the developer's dues are cleared. Now, buyers have taken the company to the consumer court seeking fair compensation for the time lost. The case in National Consumer Disputes and Redressal Commission is listed for hearing on May 30th. And buyers are hopeful that recent judgments by NCDRC will help them get justice. Chanakya Patia for NDTV. Now it is time to take a break, and after we come back, we will tell you where you can find affordable homes in promising destination of Agra. And a new launch in Lucknow, Central Park by MI Builder in our Project Dragons.